Strap yourself in and get ready to feel the G's because we are taking a 90-minute romp all the way to first base. Let's get started. Hello, everybody. I'm Andrew Fantasia. Welcome to Thumb Together. And today we're going to be talking about Good Boys Together. As usual, if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to give it a thumbs up and give some love to that subscribe button as well. Otherwise, nobody's going to kiss me at all. I won't get kissed, even at a kissing party. Which is apparently a thing. If you have seen even one trailer for Good Boys, I think right away you can make the assumption it is super bad with 12-year-olds. And if you make that assumption, you are pretty much absolutely right. It is super bad with 12-year-olds. It's a trio of friends who are not the most popular kids in school, but guess what? The popular kids are having a party. And at the party, it is expected that some kissing is going to go down. And one of the kids, Jacob Tremblay, he wants to kiss a girl he has had a crush on for a very long time. And the whole movie is this odyssey of them trying to collect what they believe they need in order to get to this party and be ready for some kissing, for some first base action. And that's Good Boys in a nutshell. But is Good Boys a good flick? And I think the answer is yeah, it's a pretty good flick, but don't expect super bad good. I don't know what it is about super bad, but my god, that movie was just friggin' lightning in a bottle. It was so good, and nothing has touched it since. There have been so many movies that have been sort of along the same lines, these sweet coming of age, you know, raunchy comedies that Hollywood is very good at making. We've had so many. Like last year we had Blockers. Blockers was fantastic, but it just wasn't super bad fantastic. I don't know why we can't get comedies that reach that level anymore. I don't understand why it's so hard to do. I understand that it is hard to do, but I don't understand why the best people in the world at making comedies can't make a comedy, again, that's as good as Superbad was, but I digress. We're not here to talk about Superbad. We're here to talk about Good Boys, and Good Boys was good, but it wasn't amazing. The quest that these three boys go on throughout the course of the movie, it keeps getting more and more insane. I feel like all the dominoes were in place for this to be outstanding, for this to be an A-plus motion picture. So it feels weird to say at the end of it all that it wasn't, because I can't really think of very much that was wrong with the movie, to be honest. Like, I can't pinpoint things, except for one thing, which I'll get to later, but I can't pinpoint anything where I'm like, ooh, they dropped the ball here, and they dropped the ball with this, and they should have done this. I don't know, maybe I just haven't given it enough thought, but everything that Good Boys set up was great, and all the payoff to that setup was good, because I had a good laugh out of it, but it never hit that point where I was like, this is a comedy that people are going to be talking about for years to come. And it's a shame, because I think everybody involved did a really, really good job. I think all three of these boys were fantastic. I think the supporting cast was great. I think that the writing was actually really good. There were a lot of nice little moments that just kind of flowed from one to the other. So it was a very well put together movie from every angle. From a writing standpoint, from an acting standpoint, from a directing standpoint, it was just a really well put together movie. It just didn't feel like a comedy gold masterpiece. And the thing is, I wasn't sitting in that theater trying to actively keep comparing it to movies like Superbad. I wasn't sitting there with these expectations. I was just going to be like, okay, this looked funny in the trailers. Bring it over. Let's have it. Let's have some Good Boys. So it's not like I was setting the standards too high going in. It's not like I wasn't giving the movie a fair chance. I was just ready to just sit there and let it wash over me. And once it washed over me, I was like, this is really good, but I really can't say what it's missing. I'm floored, because that usually doesn't happen here, does it? Usually I can confidently say, like, this didn't work because of this, and this worked because of that. So Good Boys is kind of an enigma in that way. But like I said, I can point to one specific thing that really didn't work for me, and I'm going to put a teensy-weensy spoiler warning up just in case, because this thing involves the end of the movie. I don't know what's going on in the world of comedy writers down in Hollywood for the past decade and a half. I really don't understand what's going on down there, but it feels like nobody can write a fucking ending to a comedy. I don't get it. I don't get it, baby. Somebody please explain to me why this is so hard to accomplish. The end of Good Boys, like the last minute of Good Boys, sucked. It sucked because it was a joke we saw in the trailer, and it was a joke that made no sense in the context of the scene. It felt like it was wedged in there. I'll need to say what the joke is, which is why the spoiler warning was up, in order for you to understand why it sucked. It's the joke you see in the trailer with the sex swing, okay? Where they're like, hey, my parents have a swing in their room, let's play on it. That's funny because it suits their characters. They're these naive kids who don't understand all these sex things. But the movie is about them growing and, getting to a point where they're trying to mature past what was plaguing them throughout the film. During the film, there are lots of fun moments like that where they're like, what's this? They're holding up like anal beads and they're like, oh, what are these? And maybe it's a necklace, maybe it's a nunchuck, whatever. And it's fun because you're seeing them play around with these things that you would normally never see a child touching. If that sex swing scene had been in the middle of the movie when that stuff was going on, it would make perfect sense and that scene would be fine. It'd be great. I'd have no problem with it. But it was shoehorned at the end, like so jarringly. You have this emotional ending that I thought was going to sort of build to something, I don't know what, just something interesting with like a nice punch to the ending. And then it's literally just like one of the characters says, hey, by the way, I totally forgot. Come to my parents' room. I want to show you something. Look, a swing. And then his little sister walks in like you see in the trailer and she's like, that's a sex swing. That's for sex. And the boys are just like, oh. And then they cut to credits. Honestly, I feel like there's some kind of rule in Hollywood where if you're writing a comedy, you have to have a weak ending because that's all I'm seeing now. This is just a trend in comedy films. It's like, okay, let's write our A material for 90 minutes, and then for the final minute, let's write our F material. I honestly don't get it. I don't get what they were thinking. Like, how do you, a professional writer, not know how to write an ending to a movie that is otherwise great, that otherwise you have done a great job on this movie? Why are endings so hard to accomplish? I'm legitimately asking, if anybody out there knows, why are endings to these things so hard to accomplish? Please let me know. Because as far as I'm concerned, when you look back at great comedies of the past, when you look back at your Ferris Bueller's, your Superbad's, your Hot Fuzz's, they all have good endings. So it can be done. It's not like writing an ending to a comedy is an impossible task. It can be done. So I want to know why it's not being done by anybody, especially the people who are supposed to be the pros. Seth Rogen, Evan Goldberg. I don't understand why the pros, the best in the world, can't do it. It sounds like I'm pissed and I hate this movie, and I really don't, because I'm not pissed and I don't hate this movie. I think it's a very, very good movie up until that final scene, which is just pointless and not funny and wedged in the wrong place, and a scene we saw in the trailer, so it's not like it was even a surprise. It does not belong there at all. It is a horrendous final minute to an otherwise pretty good movie. So I think if you're forewarned of that, if you go in knowing that, knowing, okay, I'm gonna watch a great film and it's gonna have a shitty ending, but other than that, I'm gonna have a good time, then I think you'll be okay. As long as you're not unpleasantly surprised by the pointless final minute on the sex swing, then you'll enjoy yourself. I think. I hope. I want you to go and watch Good Boys and enjoy yourself. Because like I said, apart from that, everybody did a pretty damn good job. And you'll have a laugh. These three kids, man, these are some funny, funny kids. Anyway, that is Good Boys. That is Thumb Together. My name is Andrew Fantasia. And if you like endings that are kind of cool, and you're looking for more endings that are kind of cool, I would suggest hopping onto Amazon.com and picking up this sexy novel right here. This is called Side Scroller. I wrote it, and I promise, the ending is better than the end of Good Boys. I promise. But thanks so much for tuning in. I will see you here next time, and until then, adios.